Has anyone here seen the movie Wag the Dog? Yeah, that's right. One. One person who is not under 30. So, in the movie Wag the Dog, they have to falsify a war, and so they use visual effects to do it. They hire a Hollywood producer. They need to make up a war, and then they bring in these visual effects people. I was a political science student at the time when I saw it, and I was like, wow, visual effects is awesome. They just like can make all these things happen in real time, like just poof, and there it is. And then when I got into Hollywood, I realized none of this shit is like that at all. It's all like insane amounts of like manual labor and months of rendering and chaos and bullshit. So I started working through the business, and I'm like, at some point when you get to the top, it must be amazing, right? And it really wasn't. I was like, okay, well, I guess that was a lie. Visual effects is not real time, but it should be. And so at every point, as I got closer and closer to the top, I was like, why aren't we doing more in real time? Why aren't we using video game engines? And so every opportunity that we had to try and use some technology like that, we would roll into the movie so that Martin Scorsese could see what he was doing. I was like, how can you make a movie when you're shooting an actor on a green screen and you're like supposed to imagine what all this other stuff is, but you can't see it, and I don't even know what it looks like, and why are we shooting the movie this way? So I always worked with people who had a similar vision. So we started working on game technology blending with cinema technology. And you may not know it yet, but there's a pretty big difference between television production, or at least there was, between television production, live television production, and film production. So I was like, why don't we just mix all these three things together? Because I had played around with video games a lot, and I had worked on television production a lot, and I worked on movie production a lot. And I was like, we should just stick all these things together. So we got into this thing called virtual production, which is the concept of taking a video game engine, putting real-time assets in it, using a real-time keyer, like from broadcast television, taking live footage out from the digital cinema cameras, and then compositing these two things together. Then you just have to track the camera footage onto the game engine background, and boom, visual effects in real time on the set so that Marty can go, Sasha, move over there. And, you know, blah, blah, blah over there, and the moon over here, and the Eiffel Tower. And the next thing you know, the director is directing the visual effects and the actor at the same time, which is great because how else can you make decisions about the creativity of a shot if I tell you, like, okay, I want you to read this book, but only the first two chapters. And then in 8 months, I'm going to bring you back chapter 3 and chapter 4. And then 6 months after that, I'm going to bring you... It's like, it's insane. You can't remember what's going on. Like, there's no consistent narrative there. You're trying to remember what you decided like 8 months ago. It doesn't make any sense. So we started working on that approach. We ran into a limitation with cinema being high frame rate, high dynamic range, and stereographic. And we were like, directors now are trying to make a really strong emotional connection with the audience on a physical and biological level, right? Like, I can see it in stereo, so it feels more real. It's high frame rate, so it feels more like real life. All these things that people, you know, either love or hate. But generally speaking, I was like, but they're all still in a rectangle, and they're all still through a lens, and they're all still forcing your head to be somewhere. And so we decided to stop. I was like, movies are going to run into a boundary. They're going to continue to be great at what they are, and they're going to continue to be great doing what they're doing, but we have to remove that rectangle, and we have to put the audience inside the movie. We had succeeded in putting the director, to some extent, inside the movie. Now we need to put the audience inside the movie and let them discover the journey for themselves. I don't clearly know how that was going to work out, but we started a company based on that concept. So now, this is that company, and we have about 63 people, maybe 64, and we've been working on combining all of those things in virtual reality. I'm very proud of the people at that company because they've earned these. So over the course of the previous, you know, few decades, all of us at the company have gotten some Oscars and some Emmys, and the other awards on the end are the best trophy that you can get for TV commercials. So commercials, television, and movies. And we have gotten a lot of cool clients, and we've been concentrating almost exclusively on virtual reality. So we've been doing things for Facebook and things for Disney, and we've done stuff for, you know, big companies. But right now, virtual reality isn't really too much of a thing. But I was super surprised when I came here to see that you have a full lab that does augmented reality and virtual reality, and you have all the latest and greatest stuff. And you have 3D printers, so you can print all this stuff, you can make custom pieces of hardware, you can engineer the stuff. There are people in the lab that I spent time with today who know how to run all this stuff and can build things and can teach you how to build things. And realistically speaking, it will be important for you to learn sound production. It will be important for you to learn editing. It will be important for you to learn digital cinema and motion graphics and title animation and animation, rigging and modeling and all of these things, because whether you use them on the movie business or whether you use them on television shows or whether you use them to make webisodes or whether you just put them all into virtual reality, you're going to need those things in the future of media.